what can you tell us about this upcoming season?
We can tell you that you're gonna see some characters that you've known for 6 years, who are all in new places in their lives and in their particular stories. You're gonna see a version of Henry who has had some adventures, who's learned some things, who has had some trials and tribulations, and who has been changed in some very significant ways. And we'll discover through the season whether those changes are more positive or negative. He's at a big turning point in his life. We also meet some new characters like Cinderella.
Well, you know what's interesting is the last 6 seasons you met young Henry, and young Henry was the believer, and he was the one that was driving, you know, the real belief system between all these people. Believe, I believe, you have to believe, and there are happy endings, and we have to get to these happy endings, and they did get a lot of happy endings by the end of last season. And then his story, he was so busy getting everybody else's story, you know, written, and everybody else's happy endings done and solved, that now he needs to go out and find what is his purpose, what is his life like. So he ends up leaving at a young age and then growing up and getting to a different place, and that's how we start season 7. What has happened to Henry in the time, from the time that he's been, because he was sheltered all these 6 seasons by the love of both mothers and other people around him. So now he's gone out on his own, and I'm sure, as you know, growing up and being alone, leaving your home, you're going to hit some hardships in life. And that's gonna take a different toll on you in a different life. And I think then, just when you think hope is gone, and I do believe that that's where we are right now. We've finished 6 seasons. Just when you think something was done, there's about a new journey about to begin, and that's where we start. So he goes out to find his own story and find his own happy ending. And there's a lot of vibes between Cinderella and Henry. And she's edgy, you know. She's a different kind of Cinderella. She's not a damsel in distress. She's been through a lot. You know, she's got the stepmother that has taken so many, you know, she's put her through so much, and now we see Cinderella kind of fighting back and saying, hey, what is my life like? And I don't want to put up with this, and now let me find what can I do about with me right now. And I think that's what we pick up. What happens to Cinderella after she leaves home? What happens after 12 o'clock, after midnight?
How is it for you on a personal level to take this classic character and kind of see her in a new way?
Groundbreaking for me, and on a level of, you know, when you grow up, no matter where you're from, what country you're from, what ethnicity you're from, when you read fairy tales, you're hopeful and you feel like you want to believe in something bigger than anything you know. And so I cried the entire day when I found out that I was playing Cinderella, because never in the realm of any reality did I ever think I was going to get a chance to play this character that was written many, many, many moons ago. But the universal themes of what a fairy tale is, in this particular one, the love story, the pain, the struggle, is something that everyone can relate to. It's just going to be a different kind of pain and a different kind of set of struggles because of what she's going through. And you get to see her as a mother in the real world as well. And that child, Lucy, being now the believer and taking us on a different journey.